Hey guys, welcome to Filmora Pro. My name's Johnny, and today I wanted to show you how you could pull off this really cool title transition effect. There are some really cool techniques on display here that might even inspire you to make your very own custom title cards. Now, if you're new to Filmora Pro or interested to see what it's all about, you can download it, link in the description below, and try it out for yourself. Once you have it installed, I highly recommend you take a look at our text and titles video in our Learn Filmora Pro playlist. It's got a ton of good info in there, a good baseline before you jump into this. Link also in the description. Anyway, let's take a look at this effect. Alright, so there's obviously a lot going on here. We've got a plane with an effect for our background, and some 3D looking text flickering in and out of existence on the top. Today we're going to demystify all the cool stuff going on in here. And we're going to learn some cool keyboard shortcuts. Finally, if you haven't already, make sure to give us a like and hit that subscribe button for more tutorials like this one in the future. With that out of the way, let's make this title from scratch. So our first step would be to create a new plane. The color doesn't matter. All that matters is that the plane is the same size as the project, which it should be by default. I'm going to trim down my plane's duration to about 2.5 seconds, since I want something relatively quick. Next, let's add a color gradient effect onto our plane. I'm going to choose a start color, like maybe a nice deep blue. And something kind of teal or mint for our end color. There we go. Next, we want to animate this effect so that for the duration of the title, the gradient shifts around. I'm going to start with my start color in the top left-ish area, and my end color in the bottom right. With my playhead at the beginning, I'll click the circle beside each position to enable keyframing. Finally, I'll jump ahead to the end of the clip by hitting the down arrow key, and I'll create a new keyframe for the start and end of the gradient by moving both points to different parts in the frame. Let's take a look at that. Let's adjust the position at the start so that we can see the colors moving a little bit more. There we go. Alright, now let's animate the position of this plane. We want it to come in from the left and leave off the right end. So, with our playhead about 20 frames in, let's enable position keyframing by clicking this circle. You can find all of this under the transform heading. Let's go to the beginning of the clip by pressing the up arrow key. And let's lower the X position so that the plane disappears off the left side of the frame. Next, let's press the down arrow key to go to the end, and then hold shift and press the left arrow key twice to move back 20 frames. And here we'll create another position keyframe by pressing the forward slash key. Finally, we'll go back to the end of the clip by pressing the down arrow key again, and we'll create a keyframe by adjusting our X position so that our plane moves completely off the right side of the frame. Here's what it looks like. Not bad, though I would really like to smooth out this motion. Let's highlight all of our position keyframes and click this circle icon up here to convert these into Bezier keyframes. Bezier keyframes are similar to smooth keyframes in that they allow us to smooth out the animation. Next, we'll toggle the graph view, and I'm going to lengthen these Beziers right here to further smoothen out our motion. Just like this. Now we should have something that looks like this. Next, let's create our title text. I'm going to name mine Custom Transition. You don't want something that big for this effect. And I'll place it in the middle. First, I'm going to make a flickering in and out effect by animating our text's opacity. Before we get 20 frames in, we'll want our text to fully appear, but we don't want to start seeing it until after our background has slid in behind it. So I'm going to choose this moment about 10 frames in, and I'll set the opacity to 0 and enable keyframing. We'll move forward 2 frames by pressing the right arrow key twice, and we'll set the opacity to 50. We'll move ahead 1 more frame, set the opacity back to 0, 2 more frames forward, we'll now set the opacity to 100, 2 more frames forward, set the opacity to 50, and finally 1 last frame forward, and set the opacity to 100. This is all pretty random, by the way, since I'm trying to pull off a random flickering effect, so if you don't do exactly what I do here, that's fine. To complete this effect, let's highlight all of these keyframes and press the square icon up here to convert them into constant keyframes. This will make it so that our opacity jumps between these keyframe values rather than smoothly moving between them. Now I'm going to do the same thing for the end. Let's start right here with a keyframe. And then 1 frame later, let's set the opacity to 0. 1 later, let's set it to 100. And finally, 2 later, let's bring it back to 0. Turn all of those into constant keyframes, and now we should have a nice flickering effect. Alright, next let's add a cool zooming in effect by keyframing the scale. I'll choose a moment when the text has finished flickering, and then set a scale keyframe by pressing this circle beside scale. Next, let's hold shift while we press the right arrow to move ahead 10 frames, and adjust our scale. Let's turn these into Bezier keyframes and really draw out the curves like this. That way we'll get a really nice animated zoom effect. Let's take a look at that. And I'm going to dial it back just a little bit. Looks good! But we can do a few things to really make this text pop out. First, let's add a perspective warp effect. At the very beginning of our clip, let's set a swing keyframe and set it to negative 36, and a roll keyframe also at negative 36. Next, let's set our latitude to 17. Let's go to the end of the clip and change these swing and roll values to 44 and 44. Let's also make sure wrap X and wrap Y are turned off. This will now give us a 3D look that we're going for. Next, let's add a blur effect. We'll only want this blur to appear as the text is zooming in to imitate a camera trying to get back into focus. Let's first zero our blur radius and then set a blur radius keyframe right as the text is starting to zoom in. Next, let's move ahead to when the text finishes zooming in and crank our radius up to about 10 pixels. Finally, let's move ahead a few more frames and set our radius back to 0. Let's highlight all of these keyframes and click the filled-in diamond icon to convert them all into smooth keyframes. And finally, I'm going to add a neon glow effect to this title. I'll set the intensity to 0.6 and choose a nice bright cyan for the color. Finally, let's set our blend to add. We'll set our expansion to 5 and our radius to 30. And I'm actually going to tweak my color a little bit here. And there we have it, a cool title transition card. If we want to export this file to drop onto another project, we should use a format that supports transparency like ProRes 4444 Alpha if you're on Mac, or a format like Uncompressed AVI with Alpha if you're on Windows. So that's how you can make a cool text transition in Filmora Pro. Did you guys learn anything? Let us know in the comments down below. If you want to learn more things in Filmora Pro, make sure to hit that subscribe button. And remember, there's no limit to what you can make.